Hi, I'm Dan with FreshPoint, and let's take a few minutes and go over the basics of grapes. Grapes come in three different colors, and that's really how we buy and sell them. There's red, green, and black. Black is the least popular, but in fact may be the most flavorful. So if you're looking to add a little splash of flavor and color to your menu, seek out some black seedless grapes. Grapes have multiple USDA standards. In California and Arizona, in addition to the physical standards, they do have Brix requirements. And you may wonder, what is a Brix requirement? Well, we use a tool called the refractometer, and it tests and gives us the percentage of sugar in the fruit. So it's a baseline of the discussion. We want to see high Brix, which indicates that the grapes were allowed to fully mature on the vine. So when you get your grapes in, what do you need to look for? You want to make sure your grapes are dry in the package. You want to make sure there's no signs of mold or decay. You also want to look for something called shatter. And shatter is essentially the grapes that have fallen off the vine in transit or in handling. Now, it doesn't affect the flavor at all. They're still delicious, but what it does is it affects the appearance of the bunch. If you're using the bunch as a garnish or in a presentation, if you have bunches with a lot of shatter, you're going to have some empty spots, and it's going to affect that. The vast majority of the table grapes consumed in the United States are seedless. There still, however, are seeded varieties. You can see it's a larger berry. It does have seeds. So if you want a little bit of impressive size on your fruit plates, consider using the red globe. Just be sure to remind people that there are seeds in them. Times of the year, you'll see ambering and green grapes. And ambering is just a brownish color. It's not decay, it's not old. It's really indicative of higher sugar content. Typically, it's towards the end of the season. It doesn't affect anything other than the visual appearance. Keep your grapes dry. Wash them just prior to using. They don't really want to sit wet. They'll break down a lot faster. Avoid dropping them. That leads to shatter. That also damages and can even burst the berries. Don't stack heavy objects upon them. And really order exactly what you need. Don't keep too many on hand because the shelf life tends to go down the higher the moisture and the higher the sugar content of the product. I'm Dan with FreshPoint, and that was the basics of grapes.